Hi, my name is Raj Singh, and I run the LSU AgCenter Plant Diagnostics Center, and I'm also an extension pathology specialist for horticulture crops. This morning, I'm going to discuss a very destructive disease of tomatoes, peppers, eggplants, potatoes with you. The disease is called Southern Bacterial Wilt. As the name indicates, it is a bacterial disease. The name of bacteria is Ralstonia solanaceorum. The disease is soil-borne, and it has about a little over 200 plant species as its host. The bacterium will enter the roots through wounds and injuries, and then colonize the vascular bundles of the plant and clogs them, interrupting the water supply. So the initial symptoms that you will see with this disease is that the plant starts wilting. They will wilt in the heat of the day and may come back in the evening hours, but eventually in a couple of days, the plant will wilt and it won't come back. And that's when you call it Southern Bacterial Wilt. Symptoms of Southern Bacterial Wilt include wilting of the plants. Like I mentioned, it is a root pathogen, so once it enters the plant system, it will clog the vascular bundles and interrupt the water supply, so your plants are not getting water being transported to the rest of the plant. The lack of water can also produce similar kind of symptoms, but if you water the plant will come back. In this case, once the bacterial infection has occurred, the plant will never recover from that wilting. So your plants will wilt permanently. Another diagnostic feature or symptom that you can tell in the field is the discoloration of the vascular bundles. There is a field test that you can do. If you take out a wilted plant and remove the dirt from the bottom of the plant and cut it at the soil line and suspend a portion of the stem in water in a clear glass and let it sit for about, let's say, 30 seconds. If it is bacterial wilt, then the bacterium will start oozing out of that bottom end of the cut stem, and it appears like a milky oozing out of that. So that could be one of the diagnostic feature. But if you're not sure, then you can definitely send the samples to LSU AgCenter Plant Diagnostic Center, and we can run tests on it to confirm that it is bacterial wilt. Why we need to confirm it is a bacterial wilt? Because there are other fungal vascular diseases that can cause similar kind of symptoms. The only difference between these two diseases is that the fungi will take longer to produce those symptoms, whereas in bacterial wilt, the plants will start dying within a week or 10 days. When it comes to management of Southern Bacterial Wilt, unfortunately, there is no chemical that can be applied to manage the bacterium in the soil. It is a soil-borne disease, so the bacterium can stay in the soil for up to 3 to 5 years, even in the absence of the host. So if you suspect that you have Southern Bacterial Wilt in your gardens or in your field, and if you can afford or if you can move to another location to plant your tomatoes, eggplants, or peppers, or tomatoes, or potatoes, that would be the best thing to do. If you decide to move to a new location, we recommend that you do not bring any tools that were used in the previously infected fields. If you have to bring those tools, make sure you surface disinfect them or clean them properly so there is no dirt left on those tools from the previous fields. We recommend not to use those stakes from the previous field, so try to use new stakes. But if you don't have enough area, or if you cannot move to a new location, you have to implement an integrated disease management practice to combat Southern Bacterial Wilt. Like I said, there is no chemical control for this disease, and the bacterium is soil-borne. So one of the methods that we use to reduce the population of bacterium in the soil is soil solarization. If you're not sure about soil solarization, there are some very good demonstrations online that you can use to see how soil solarization is done. Again, the idea with soil solarization is to reduce the population of the bacterium in the upper soil layers. We recommend raised beds. Now, if you do the raised beds and if you had disease in that same plot before, we don't want to till those raised beds in your native soil. Also, we recommend crop rotation. Now, when you do the crop rotation, you have to be really careful that you want to use a non-host crop like corn, beans, or cabbage. If you do that rotation, again, with all these management practices, the idea is to reduce the population of the bacterium so that it is unable to cause that infection. If you need more information on how to manage and how to ID sudden bacterial wilt in fields, we have a fact sheet on sudden bacterial wilt on lsuagcenter.com. Or you can call us anytime at from 8 to 5 at 225-578-4562. Thank you.